So Mosquito Mate is based on some technology that we developed at UK.
The idea is that we're rearing lots of mosquitoes in the laboratory. We remove the females. Female mosquitoes bite. Instead, we release only the male mosquitoes, which don't bite. We release lots and lots of these male mosquitoes, which have this Wolbachia bacterium.
The mosquitoes will find females on their own. They're quite good at that. This is what they've evolved to do.
And then they mate with the females in the field and effectively sterilize them.
So there are several advantages of our approach.
We don't use chemicals. It's a naturally occurring bacterium.
Traditional insecticides have the potential to impact bees, butterflies, things that we see as beneficial in our backyard and beneficial to the ecosystem for that matter. So our approach is specific only to the Asian tiger mosquito. This technology does not involve genetic modification.
By using a naturally occurring bacterium, by using the mosquito's natural ability to find mates, we can come up with a better approach that hopefully will work better and complement existing approaches. To get it out of the lab benches and get it in the field where it can actually help people, we've been working with the Von Allman Center here at the University of Kentucky. They've really been very helpful in taking the technology and moving it into the field. So we started in small cages, we moved to larger cages, and moved to field cages, and in each case it worked very well at suppressing and eliminating the population. And so now, as a kind of the final step, we're moving into the field for suppression.
So we're testing this approach on a neighborhood level in order to satisfy requirements from the EPA in order for us to sell this product to homeowners.
And so the next big step is to demonstrate efficacy, to actually go and do field releases, and not just at one site. We're doing it here in Kentucky, but we also have collaborators in California, Florida, New York.
We're having our employees show up at a targeted site, and basically what we do is walk around the perimeter of the house, which distributes the mosquitoes within that area pretty evenly. And what we expect to see is, as we continue these releases of male mosquitoes, we'll see a corresponding reduction in hatch rate, which subsequently should result in lower densities of biting females that would result from those eggs.
With that evidence, we can then go back to the EPA and apply for a full registration. The best case scenario is that it works. Something that started as an idea and very basic research can get carried all the way through to the field and then ideally actually help people.
Most recently, a new virus, chikungunya virus, has invaded the Caribbean.
There is the concern that we could start having local transmission where mosquitoes are picking it up and transmitting it here within the U.S.
Developing technology here that is useful for people is, you know, something that we strive to do, and having something that could be so meaningful for the people, whether it's reducing mosquito-borne disease or just allowing people to relax in their backyard without getting mosquito bites, is something that we think is worthwhile.